I'm calling this page 8 warning. Page 8 in my book, Toxic, shamelessly plugging my book, but I talk about this book so much because it's so jam-packed with information that is ageless, that is genderless, that affects all of us in today's world. But every once in a while, I come across a quote that blows my mind that is so applicable to what it is that we're all experiencing. So listen to this. I'm just going to read you one paragraph. Toxic chemicals may be triggering recent increases in neurodevelopment disabilities among children, such as autism, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, ADHD, and dyslexia. The researchers say a new global prevention strategy to control the use of these substances is urgently needed. In quotes, "The greatest concern is the large numbers of children who are affected by toxic damage to brain development in the absence of a formal diagnosis," end quotes, says Philippe Grandjean, adjunct professor of environmental health at Harvard School of Public Health. Another quote, "They suffer reduced attention span, delayed development, and poor school performance, and industrial chemicals are now emerging as the likely causes," end quotes. The authors say it's crucial to control the use of these chemicals to protect children's brain development worldwide. Harvard School of Public Health, February 14th, 2014. Not me saying it, Harvard is saying it. You wonder why all the kids today have all these terrible brain disorders, and you wonder why the only antidote that our practitioners have come up with is to put them on amphetamines, to put children on amphetamines whose brains are not fully formed yet. Amphetamines are Vyvanse, Adderall, Concerta. It allows them to be focused. I've recently been interviewing holistic psychiatrists who have a whole new approach. Rather than just putting them on the prescribed amphetamine, instead, by doing blood work, seeing where their nutritional and mineral deficiencies are, by reinstating the nutritional and mineral deficiencies, and as she builds this up, both of these holistic psychiatrists I've been interviewing are women, they're able to reduce the amphetamine to a point where eventually they can take the child off the amphetamine. That can only be good. So if you are with a doctor who says, the only thing I can do for the fact that your child has these brain issues is put them on an amphetamine, I'd like you to know that there are other doctors out there who are thinking differently, who are making a difference, and it will make such a difference in the life of your child. If you want to find a holistic psychiatrist, go to foreverhealth.com. It's a free service that will bring you to a doctor nearest you. There aren't a lot of holistic psychiatrists. You may have to travel or do a Skype. They both do Skype interviews, which would be quite wonderful. But there's another way, and I think the healthiest way. It's all about putting back what is missing. And what is missing in the brains of these children are the right minerals and nutrients, and it's not an amphetamine deficiency. Hope this helps.